Lately, I've been designing and building smaller TV antennas that are really working quite well. Here's my latest design, the 3-diamond antenna, and it gets great reception. I'm going to show you how to make your own, so let's hop to it. Antennas are kind of like socket wrenches in that one size does not necessarily fit all. Different nuts need different sockets. With antennas, different locations may need a different type of antenna for best reception. For example, some of you may live in the city with lots of transmitters near you. Others may be more rural and have less transmitters that may be in various directions. Still, some of you could be very rural with long distances between your TV transmitters and your antennas. An antenna for each of these situations could be very different. That's why there are so many different TV antenna designs. You'll have to do a bit of homework to figure out your specific needs. I recommend starting your research with the website rabbitears.info. It's a great site to give you all the basic information you need to decide which antenna design is best for your location. I have an episode dedicated to showing you step by step how to best use the website's tools and charts. For your convenience, I'll link it at the end of this video. The 3-diamond antenna is multi-directional. It has been designed with a very thin profile and it's about 19 inches across, so it's stealthy and easy to hide. Construction is quick and simple and only uses a minimum number of readily available parts. This antenna is designed to receive most UHF TV channels and has an approximate range of 35 to 40 miles. The precise range is going to be dependent on the specifics of your location. Well, like I always say, that's enough talking, let's get to building. I start off with a piece of 1x6 PVC board. I use PVC as it's weather resistant and will last a long time. Next, I need 84 inches of wire. I'm using 10 gauge Romex copper as it's stiff and makes a good antenna element. I'll also need 7 inches of copper connecting wire. I have some 14 gauge that will work perfectly for it. I will be using 6 number 8x9/16 inch lath screws to assemble the parts. Also, I have a 1 1/2 inch screw to secure the antenna to the mounting mast. For my test mast, I'm just going to use 1/2 inch PVC with a cap on the end, but feel free to design whatever you need for your situation. I'll start by cutting an equilateral triangle from the 1x6 inch board. I measure up 4¾ inches from the bottom edge. Now I measure in 2¾ inches, which is the center line. Using a straight edge, I draw a line from each corner to this point. I cut out the triangle and now I locate the center of it. I draw guidelines from each point to the center mark. Next, I measure down from the triangle point 1 1/2 inches and make a mark 1/2 inch on either side of the line. I repeat this for the other two angles. If you're enjoying this video, then please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Using a 1/8 inch drill bit, I drill 6 pilot holes about 1/4 inch deep into the board. I also drill out the center mark, boring all the way through to the other side. I screw the 1 1/2 inch screw into the hole. Taking the length of 10 gauge wire, I cut it into 3 equal 28 inch lengths. Each length is marked at 7, 14, and 21 inches from one end. Using a pair of needle nose pliers, I make a sharp bend at the 7 inch mark. The idea is to make this a 90 degree angle, but for now, close is good enough. I repeat the bends at both the 14 and 21 inch marks and end up with a square shape. I want the wire to be on the same plane, so I make any adjustments as necessary. Using the needle nose pliers again, I bend in terminal hooks at the end of each wire square. I take the 14 gauge wire and cut it into 2 3.5 inch lengths. I bend terminal hooks into each end, then I measure them against the triangle terminal points like this to make sure they fit. These will act as jumpers between the antenna elements. The 6 last screws are inserted into the pilot holes. I put them through the 2 jumper wires to secure them in place. Now I take each of the element squares and slip the ends under the terminal screws like this. I align the points with the tips of the triangle and tighten them down in place. I drill a hole in the top of the 1/2 inch PVC cap and I drive the 1.5 inch screw through the triangle into it to secure it all together. Final adjustments are made and I make sure everything is aligned and the elements are as flat to each other as possible. That's it, the antenna is done and it took me less than an hour to make. Let's take it up to my test TV and see how well it works. To attach the cable to the antenna, I use a matching transformer. If you don't have one, you can order one very inexpensively from Amazon. You can just attach the inner and outer cable wires directly to the antenna without matching transformer, but this degrades the antenna's performance, so I don't recommend it. The 3-diamond antenna is attached to my test TV. I run a full channel scan to see what I can receive. The average reception is about 39 channels, so I'm hoping to get better than that. The scan is complete and this antenna is pulling in 44 channels, which is quite impressive, especially for such a small antenna. I check out the more difficult to receive channels. Channel 62, Bounce TV, is a marginal station. This antenna pulls it in with a good 2-bar signal. The local PBS stations are always difficult and usually need a more directional antenna to receive them. With this antenna, I'm getting 2 bars with a good stable signal. The farthest transmitter that I was able to pick up was right at about 40 miles away with 1-bar signal. Not too shabby for an unamplified antenna. So there it is, a simple, small, easy to make TV antenna that works very well. The 3-diamond antenna is simple to construct, so why not make one for your TV? For just an hour of your time and a few basic materials, you can tell your cable provider so long and enjoy watching free local stations. Save that money for something more important like food or rent. Folks, don't forget to high-five the like icon, jingle the bell, and subscribe to my channel. A huge thanks to all of you that have already subscribed. You are terrific and I cannot thank you enough. Wonder what I'm making next? Well, that's a good question. Until next time, keep watching TV.